running, no gunshots, but they getting low, 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 low.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. So today, normally I'd be doing a county line video today, but as you can see in my background here, I have a picture. We have John Deere 8820 Titan II combine, Alice Chalmers 8030 pulling a Iver Firth 6500, and then we got a Chevy C70 grain truck. Well, I had posted pictures of this yesterday, and I had a lot of people ask me if I've done a video on this truck yet, and you know, when I said no, I got a lot of people saying that I should. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you guys the three versions of this truck that I already have finished, and then we're going to work on one version that I have close to done. So we'll start off here. We're going to hop in game. I've got my Westbridge Hills test save game loaded up. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to buy these trucks. I'm actually going to put a bunch more money in first. And save. Okay, so under trucks, we have them all right here. So here we have the first one. This is the single axle black box dyeable cab. We're going to go with a nice, we're going to go with blue. $7,600. It has a capacity of 21,742 liters. And then same with this one. All that stuff is the same here. I do need to put a maintenance price on these things yet. And I do need to adjust the cube map as well. Still have a few things that need to be adjusted. They're not perfect yet, but they're good enough. Anyway, then here we have another single axle version. This one is made to replicate my great-grandpa's old truck, so we'll go ahead and buy that one. And then we have the tandem axle version. This one costs $13,500 to buy. Has a capacity of 26,041 liters. So these ones, the way that I figured out how much these hold is I did a lot of conversion stuff. So first I figured out the size of the box in cubic feet. Basically did that by multiplying the width times the height times the length. So it's 6 foot high, 8 foot wide, 16 feet long. So you multiply all that, figure out how many bushels are in a cubic foot, divide the number that you got by multiplying length, width, and height. You divide that by 0.8, then that gives you your number, and then you go and convert it from cubic feet to bushels, and then convert that from bushels to liters, and away you go. So this one has a 20-foot box on it, and like I said, 26,041 liter capacity. This one also has a dyeable cab. We'll go with red on this one. So let's go ahead and we'll take a look at them here. So here they are. The truck is from Polygonish. It did have a dump bed on it, but he did not put a door on the back. So I used the one from the Lodestar grain truck that you guys had seen me doing some work to a while ago. And yeah, so let's go ahead and hop in. It does have an interior. Steering wheel does not turn. And I do have a couple pieces in here that get dirty because they aren't separated. So we'll go ahead and put the diff locks on. It has some nice Detroit diesel sounds, so we'll start that up. Lights do work. And I forgot to delete a couple of lights. But yeah, lights do work and everything. So we'll drive down to the farm. It is fully washable as well. Whoa! Jeez. So we'll go ahead here and go load up. Let's grab some wheat. Has a dynamic fill plane. The original truck, the Lodestar truck, I guess, had it. And basically, I just overlaid all of these pieces aside from the box on into the other truck. So we'll go ahead and we'll unload here. This is a scissor lift, so that's pretty cool. I did try and get the mirrors working, but I cannot get them to work at all. I don't know why. I even like copied stuff from, okay, that thing looks really weird. I copied stuff off of the one of the in-game tractors even, and I still could not get anything. So I don't know, I'll have to mess with that a little more another time and see if I can get it to work. So that's this version. So then this one's exactly the same. It's just red cab and blue box. My great grandpa has a truck like this. I don't think it's a Chevy C70. I actually think it's a GMC, but it's not that much different of a truck than this one. So I just decided I'd put red and blue on it. So I really like this truck. I really like all these trucks. They're really nice. They turned out awesome. So then here we have the tandem axle version. Basically, it's the same chassis as the other one. It just is extended a little bit, and then the axle, the drive shaft, and the leaf springs are all duplicated and adjusted to match. So we'll go ahead and we'll go do this, test this one out. I did a harvest test, as you saw on my desktop, my background. I've done a harvest test with a John Deere 80. Well, I already said that. You saw all the harvest stuff that I did. It was with this tractor for grain cart, this combine. I used this header from the John Deere S660, and it connected really, really terribly. So I did hook the MacDon D60 to it, and it worked very well. I would like to find a nice header that's just a little bit smaller than the MacDon, and that's actually John Deere, but gotta use what you got. So we'll unload this guy. I do need to mess with the cube map a little bit yet too. They're not perfect by any means, but they get the job done. I wish that I could take it off of the wood, but the wood is the same material, I think, or something like that. And yeah, so it adds it to, like, if I click on the grain box in Giant's Editor, it selects the grain box, the floor, the scissor lift, everything, and cube maps everything. I mean, it did save time. I only added the cube map, the dirt shader, and the spec map to one thing, but still, it was kind of annoying. So I'm gonna quit without saving, and we're gonna get to work here. I am currently working on a flatbed version. There are gonna be three other versions. This version, for, you know, it's a flatbed with chemical tank and all that good stuff for tending to sprayers, and this is going to be scripted so that you fill it and whatnot. This is a 300 gallon tank, I believe. I need to ask the guy that made it what size it is, but I'm pretty sure it's a 300 gallon tank. And anyway, and then there'll be a flatbed version. It's, well, exactly this same flatbed. as you can see, just this one isn't textured yet. And then these pieces here are hay racks, are going to be hay racks. So I'll be duplicating this, or I already have this flatbed duplicated, but then I'll just be taking these and adjusting it to make this into a flatbed with hay racks, and then the hay racks will be selectable in game. So then, like, you can haul hay with this and have hay racks on the sides, and it'll have load lock and whatnot. And then I'm also going to make a tender box version for filling planters and whatnot. So we're going to save that, close that, and then we can close that and open this. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to open up the Chevy C70. This is the version with dyeable cab, which is the version that I want. Dyeable is really easy to add. I'll explain it here. So all you gotta do is go to material editing. You have to bake your piece that you want white. As you can see, it is a white texture. You can't use any other color that I know of. I tried it with red and it did not work. But you put it to so let me see here. So if I delete the spec, the cube spec map, you can see here it is white. Okay. So now what you want to do is you want to add vehicle dirt shader to it, or vehicle shader dirt, which is what you need to add to make spec maps anyways. And then you look here, variation. You would change that to color mask, and then apply your spec. And there you go. So I'm just going to close that and not save it. So we also want to open the attributes tab. And we want to go to work camera. Actually, let's just leave that one closed for now. Okay, so now what we're going to do here is the flatbed is going to go where the grain bed is. The reason for that is because then I don't have to re-index anything. Because if I delete this grain bed, then some stuff will get messed up. Well, maybe not, but still, I'm going to keep everything lined in the same. So we'll import the flatbed. So there's the flatbed. We can delete the light from it. So we'll go Control X, Control V, and then move up. And then we'll delete the grain bed. And then we got to move the flatbed around a little bit. And actually what we can do is we can copy this. And then we'll just adjust it up. Uh-oh. What did I do wrong here? I did not make those long enough at all, did I? Shoot. Okay, we need to go back into Blender then. Dang it. That sucks. Yeah, those are definitely not long enough. Shoot. So I need the chassis black. And then I need the rear right and rear left. It should be big enough, but it's not. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just go like this. I'll just select all these and drop them down a ways. Oh yeah, I can see now they're sitting there above it. Shoot. Well, that's annoying. Okay, so we'll export that as bed, and we want only the selected, and we'll save it. Oops. So then we need to go bed, edit, and we want to get rid of that, change that, DDS, 10, 0, 0, and 0. Okay, so we'll import the bed. That'll go under flatbed. Oops. And then we'll delete that flatbed. And bada bing, bada boom. Away we go. Dang, and that's still not long enough. Oh, jeez. Okay, back into Blender we go again. We can also delete flatbed. Man, I figured that'd be long enough for sure. Okay, we'll go like that. And that should be plenty long enough there. If that's not, then something's terribly messed up. Export selected. Bed. We'll just leave it open for now, I guess. Till we can make sure all this is fixed. Oops. Okay. And I'm still... Okay, yes, I am. Okay, this should be plenty tall enough now. And if it's not, I'm seriously going to be mad. Okay, perfect. Now, is this back far enough? Yes, it is. Awesome. So now we have the flatbed. So now we'll go through and add our dirt and spec map. Oh, attributes. I didn't... not remember that there for a second. Okay, so first let's go change our lights. Default light corona. Visibility. Okay, so let's get rid of those. Okay, Corona. Orange. So this can be a full 90. And then this one will go back here. Oh, no wonder why my speed's up at 50. We'll go down to 15 here. Okay, we'll go Control Shift C, and then it should be this guy right here. There we go. So negative 90. And then this needs to be negative 1. Perfect. Okay, so then I gotta get some brake lights imported as well. Or some turn signals, I mean. It has brake lights, but. Okay, so this is. I don't know why the visibility is off on those. Okay, so let's get this moved. So we have the brake lights. So I'll have to re-index the brake lights because I just removed them from the truck since they weren't positioned the way that they should be. For this truck, anyways. I mean, they were fine on the other truck, on the original, but they just don't work for this. So this has reverse lights too. Okay, so we got those. Shoot, wrong one. Brake lights. Control shift C. Control shift V. Control shift C. And control shift V. Okay, so now we can do these other red Coronas. So this needs to be 90. And then actually we can copy this orange one. Okay, so we can copy this. Then we need this one. This one. There we go. So then this is 0, 90, 0, Control Shift V, and then negative 1. Okay, so we got all our lights on it. All that are in here. I'll import some more here in a little bit. Okay, so now we're gonna add our stuff to it. Okay, let's see how this looks with cube on it. Terrible. No way am I leaving cube on that. No, thank you. Orange lights, those will get dirty. So this is basically a modding video today. That's really all it is. Today and tomorrow. That looks pretty good with cube on it. Okay, I didn't think it added it to that. Now I'm gonna take a quick second to ask the guy that made this how big of a tank he modeled this for, capacity-wise. I'm gonna guess it's like a 300-gallon tank. I'm not sure. I don't know if it's that big, but like I said, I don't know. I didn't make it, So I don't know how big it is. That looks pretty good with cube on it. Man, there's a lot of pieces to this engine. It'd be nice if I just clicked engine, added the dirt, and everything got dirty. That'd be super quick and easy. Oh. Oh, that's right, because everything has the same texture. So it will. Cool. So this hose should do it too, most of it. If not all of it. Oh, nope. Anything that uses this same texture, though, will have it. There we go. So we just gotta add it to this hose, which will add it to that hose there as well. Okay. So we just gotta go to the water pump, add it in one place, I think. We'll just double check on everything that there is indeed dirt. Yep. Oh, we already checked that. Okay, so now the flatbed is dirty. Man, I need to make it bigger on that side or something. Oh no, my tire just needs to be moved in a ways. Holy crap, that thing's... It's like that on all my trucks then. Because it goes like right up to the leaf spring. So right about there. Okay, so I gotta fix that on all my other trucks now. Shoot. Okay. Let's go ahead and fix all these trucks quick. C70, where'd it go? It's right there. Extract two separate folders. Attributes, we need rear left, and this is going to be that. What? Shoot, it didn't save because I didn't even move. That's dumb. Okay, rear left. Control V. Save. There we go. So this is C70 grain truck. So we'll just move the zips out here. Rear left. See, when I was just in game earlier in the video, I kind of thought it seemed that something seemed a little off. But I couldn't figure out what. I thought maybe like my grain bed was just a little bit small or something. But that is definitely not it. Okay, so this one we gotta move two tires. We'll click save first. And this is the tandem. Okay, we'll put all these in here and replace. There we go. Okay, so now the flatbed's done. So now what we need to do is we need to go, first off, do some editing here. Okay, I will be right back. Okay, and we're back. Alright, so we can delete bed. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to edit the C70 XML. Because we need to get rid of... Okay, well, let's just get rid of... Well, that can stay. We need to get rid of moving tools. And moving parts and animations and all that stuff. There we go. And then... Fill volume. And fill sounds. Tip animations, that can go. Capacity can go. All that stuff can go. So we'll save that. Oops. And I need the mod desk. So we're going to remove those functions. And then remove that. Okay, so now I need to find a truck that's fillable. I'm trying to think of a truck that's... Well, it wouldn't even need to be a truck. I have a nurse trailer that I can use. Nurse trailer. Okay, so then we need the mod desk and the XML. So then we need to figure out how this is set up in here. Come on, give me the trigger. So we need to find 018 and 019. 018. So that's the unload trigger. Trailer trigger is 019. Supports fill triggers. Okay. Liquid manure, fertilizer, and water is all that we want on this. Tip reference point. That'd be 010. Okay, so let's... We don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need that. So we need the triggers. Water plane. What the heck is that? Yeah, we don't need that. We don't need that. So we need these. Nodes. Okay, so now if we go to our truck here, we'll import those. And holy smokes, that's huge. And of course, you can't change the size of it either. Okay, so I guess we'll just move it to the back of the truck. Wow, that's huge. Put that as fill auto aim target, I guess. Okay, so now we need to sit and look here. So let's export the turn signals off of here as well while we got them. US trailer lights, turn lights, turn left. Okay, we only need one. Are there multiples here? Sure enough, there are. Okay, so left turn. Yeah, all we need is one. Right turn. We don't need all these. Holy crap, there's a lot there. Okay, so then let's get this turn signals thing. Actually, okay. Let's see, because do I even have lights? I just have lights and reverse lights. So, yeah, I need to go from here down to there. Copy that, and then we'll go underneath of here. And we're going to take this and go control X, control V. Okay, then let's import our lights. Okay, so now let's go with brake lights. So we'll go control C. And control shift V, and then we'll move this over to the orange one. Perfect. Okay, so then we can copy this one, and it should work to just put this to negative. It should line up. Oh, pretty close. Okay, so now let's get all of our lights noded in. So we have 0, 13, 1, 0, and then 0, and then 1, 1. So the reverse lights are 0, 13, 3. Is that correct? Yes. So then brake lights. Oh, we don't need the whole thing. Okay. Is just 0, 13, 1. Okay, and then the left turn and the right turn. So this is left. Turn signal left is what I want. And then this will be the same, only one. Okay, so we got all that. Okay, now so this has the 110 and function tipper. Functions. Here we go. Okay, and then the specs is this guy right here. So then that needs to go under this. So then this only needs to be fertilizer. And we'll just leave it at the 25,000 for now, I guess. So trailer overloading. Let's see, overloading we need. I'm assuming anyways, I don't really know for sure, but that's just what I'm assuming. So store, load lock, object attacher, we don't need any of that. So now we get to go into here. So then fill sound we need. We need tip reference, tip animations, Control C, and then whoops, one more. Control V. So then our tip animations node is what am I looking for? Oh, tip reference, not tip animation. That's where I was lost. 024. Okay. Fill root node is. So we need all this stuff. Yeah, we're gonna need that, aren't we? Fill auto aim target node is 023. Where'd it go? There it is. That's this guy here. Correct. Fill auto aim target. Oops. Nope, wrong one. Okay, so we need to export that. Huh? Oh, exact fill root node. That's what we need. File, export selection, fill. We'll import that. May as well just leave it right where it is, because I'm sure that we don't need it. I don't know. Can always adjust things later. So then the node for that is 026. We only need fertilizer there. We're not going to put water in as it. Fuel fill liters per second. That takes like no time to fill then. I don't know. We'll just leave it at that. Okay, so and then I think this is all that we need yet. Yep, this should be it. But who knows? It could not be. So the trailer trigger. So, okay. Which one's 08? It really, I guess, doesn't even matter. So 22 and 25. Okay. I guess let's test it and see what happens. I don't know. So I'm going to add in a temporary store picture. We're going to make it so it doesn't show the lights. and it doesn't show the cameras. So we'll print screen, we can close that, we'll minimize that, we can close that. And we'll just paste it, slide it in. I'll add, this is just a temporary so I can see it in the store, make sure that I know which one I need. Chevy C70. Liquid tender. So we'll go in and change all this. Okay, and then we'll just move all these things out for now. They can just go there. Okay, C70 underscore liquid tender. That's what we want, that one. That's right up there with the other ones. Okay, so I will get the game loaded up, and I'll see you in game. Okay, moment of truth here. So we'll go to trucks, and then we'll just go with the default color. Okay, hit purchased. Huh. You know, it would probably help to save. Oh my god. Oh, whoops. Okay. Be back in a sec. Okay, let's try this again. I am still just... Oh, I can't believe it. Okay, there, now it's a tender truck. So, oh boy. I don't even see the stuff to fill, so I guess we'll have to just go in, go up here and try it. It does have quite a long startup sound, so. And we gotta go to the fertilizer tank. And I got my triggers, so... Oh yeah! Sweet! And it's fillable! Awesome! So, now let's buy a sprayer. Just to make sure it'll actually fill a sprayer. We'll just buy the... Rogator here. Wow! If this works, this is going to be the simplest thing I've ever done. I'm going to be super happy if this works. If this works, I'm going to be super excited. Park this here. The guy that made this tank, he did confirm this is a 300 gallon tank. So, okay, let's test all of our lights. So we got that. Sweet, all of our lights work perfectly. Sweet! This was the simplest thing I've ever done. Which, the next one won't be too hard either, because it's just a flatbed. Just put load lock on it, and away you go. So basically, delete all the triggers that we just added, and whatnot, and yeah. So we'll go get a new store image for this thing, and then we'll go back, we'll change the price, we'll change some stuff around on this truck, and then we'll go fix the other trucks as well, so that way we can get rid of that running light that's there. Okay, so we gotta back way the heck up. So first I'll take one. Like this. So just a couple of screenshots to post, and then now we'll take one just like this. So we'll just go, we'll just go like this. I am super glad that this worked the first time. I didn't have to sit and make tons of changes to it. Okay, so we'll just quit without saving. Don't need to save right now. Okay, so we need to go into the mod. Okay, so first, we need to go gallons to liters. So we'll go 300 gallons. So 1,135 liters is all that we need, or all that this will hold. 1135. Oops. No, we need to get rid of the four. And it's fuel fill liters per second will be 100. We'll go with that. And then we need to change the price on this one. We'll go 7,800. Make it a little more expensive because of the flatbed. Well, we'll go 8,000 on this one, and then the regular flatbed will go 78. Yes, I want to save that. So we can close a bunch of this stuff down now. All this stuff here can go. We'll minimize this. Okay. Sweet. That was the simplest thing I've done in a long time. That was awesome that worked right away. Okay, so we'll throw that one back in there. Okay, so now we got to edit these three again. Extract each archive to their separate folders because we got to fix this parking light here. So we need the C70. So we just got to open the one in Giant's Editor, and then the rest we'll be able to figure out the nodes for. So load star 70. We need our lights. Our reverse lights. So we can get rid of reverse lights for these trucks because they don't need them. I'm not going to delete them from here though, because I do still want to have them there. So Corona Red. So these ones we will delete because or wait. I don't need to delete the brake lights. I just need to delete those red lights. Okay, so then that's the C70. So that one's done. So then we'll go jump in here right away. We'll delete the reverse light line or lines. And then we don't even have to move from here. We just go load star 70 lights, default light, coronas, visibility on. We want that light. And so we want those two lights. Oops. Save it. Close it. And then we'll just go underscore grandpa. Whoops. Okay, and then we just got the tandem left, and we're good to go. Then we can work on the normal flatbed version. C70, reverse lights, which will basically be the C70 liquid tender that we just did. We'll just remove everything that we just finished adding and whatnot. So it's this corona red and this corona red. There we go. And then this is the tandem. Underscore tandem. There we go. So we'll throw that out there. We'll delete that. Replace all those. And we're good to go to work on the other one, the flatbed. And actually, really, I can just go off of this flatbed, so that's exactly what we're going to do. So we're going to delete all these pieces here. Shoot, that's not gonna work, is it? Okay, we'll just go like this. Okay, so now all that we're going to do is we're just going to edit this flatbed. So we're going to take all these pieces. Actually, we need to go like this. So we need to select all of these because these need to be taken off because these are going to be their own piece in game. So we can delete that flatbed because we can just use the one that we got here. Okay, so I already have all the holes in the flatbed. So, now all we gotta do is select the tops of these. Yeah, we can delete that hay rack as well. So we'll just select the tops. And we'll go E, Move them up a little bit, right about there. A little bit further down, actually. I'll go scale X. We'll scale them out to there. Then what we do, so we're going to name this Hay Rack. And then this is going to be, let's go look for a rusty brown. Kind of a dirty brown color kind of thing. I don't know. Anything good on this? Yeah, there is. Let's copy the image. And then we'll control R, make it the right size. Oh, whatever. I guess we won't, but. So then we get the little color picker. And let's go with Penny. So this will give us the hex that we need. Oops. That's not what I wanted. So we won't save that. This will be called HayRack Perfect. So now we'll make a cylinder and we'll rotate it 90 degrees this way. This is actually like my second or third time making these hay racks. I had to redo stuff a couple of times with this thing. Okay, so we'll scale it up just a little bit. Bring it up to right there, I think. Yeah, that looks pretty good. So I'm going to edit mode. We'll go like this. Whoa, what the heck just happened there? So, somebody had been asking me in the last Thursday modding, or in yesterday's video, I guess, or something like that, some video, if I could show how to make selectable things. Well, you'll get to see it in this video, because these hay racks will be selectable. So, like, if you're not hauling hay, then you can have them off, but then when you're hauling hay, they can be on. It'll be just kind of neat, I guess. So we'll join that with Hay Rack. So then all that we got to do now is just go Tab, Edit Mode, N. So all we got to do is bake the Hay Rack. We don't have to bake anything else. Everything else is done. 0.01. New, and we'll call this Hay Rack. 2048 by 2048. We're gonna make this white and uncheck alpha. We'll go here and we want full render bake. So you can see it baking over there. So then the only thing that I got to export is the hay rack. And then in Giant's Editor, we just delete all the other pieces. It'll be pretty simple. Let me guess, it's saying encoding overload. Yes, it is. Nothing I can do about that at the second. It'll go away in a moment, so. We're going to get Photoshop opening because I'm going to need it. There we go. It's all baked. So, oops, minimize. Image, we'll save as image. We'll save it to textures. And we'll open it. Hay Rack. I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so now we'll go File, Export, Giant's i3D, Export selected. This will be Hayrack. Okay, so now we're going to turn the visibility back on for everything. Take a good old screenshot here. So this might overload the encoding again, but whatever. So we're going to go Control-N. And I'm going to bring up the folder for this. Oops, that's actually in screenshot folder. Screenshots. Misc. So then this will be 3, 4, 5. Delete that one. So then this one will be, okay, so we're going to delete that one. We'll go Control N, 6. We'll screenshot that. Whoops. Paste it. And then we'll leave that B for now. So we'll go back into texture. And we're going to save this. So then we're going to get this one done in this video. And then in the next video tomorrow, we're going to work on the tender version of it. So that's what we'll do. So we need to take the Hayrack texture out of here. We're just copying that, pasting it. We're going to open this. Save it as a DDS. Delete that. We'll put that into textures. I got all kinds of textures I need to delete, don't I? Never did go and delete them. Okay, Hayrack, edit. We'll remove that. Put that. DDS. 10. 0 space, 0 space, 0. Yes. And we'll open the Chevy. View, camera, work cam. Okay, so all this stuff here can go. Flatbed, everything but the flatbed and the orange lights. We don't want to delete our lights. That would not be good. So now we'll file. Oh, we do need a... We need to export that other bed. Shoot. I didn't think of that. here. That's not hard, though. We just got to export it and then adjust things in Notepad. Same thing that we just did with the hay rack. So we're going to call that bed. We don't need to save because we didn't do anything. Edit. Okay. Textures/flatbed.dds. Whoops. My numlock is off. Why must you be so difficult? Okay, forget it then. I'll redo this. Ay, ay, ay. Guess that's what I get for not making sure my numlock is off, on, not off. Texture slash flatbed.dds. We're still going strong. That's good. So we'll import the new bed. Control X, Control V. And we'll delete that one. So we got holes in it, which is good. So we'll import the hay rack. Control X, Control V. That looks actually really cool. Okay, so we gotta take the ridge bodies off of this, otherwise we're gonna have some major issues in game. Issues that would really, really suck. So I need to go through all the folder, or the folder for the liquid tender, and the folder for this one, and delete all these textures that aren't in use. But I'll worry about that after a while. Okay, so now we're going to go dig up a file that I have not touched in so long. And actually, I just saw on Facebook that I had a memory from a year ago to share. And it was the picture of the small stack mover when I had finally finished it. And I was just like, wow, it's been a year already? I didn't think it's been that long that I did this. I have definitely learned a lot since I've done this. Maybe one day I'll go back and redo it. I don't know. Okay, so fix area and dynamic mount trigger shape. And we're just going to call this nodes for the heck of it. We'll import those. So then I have a way for changing this. We just go to rigid body and we'll change it to static. And then we just work away. So we'll go 0.5 on everything just to start out with. So we'll start off, we'll get this thing adjusted up here. So we're going to go 0.6. Let's try that. 0.7 is too big. That's perfect, right like that. So we'll bring this up to sit just like that. And that should actually be perfect. Just the way it is. We'll actually make this just a tad bit larger. Cool. Okay, so then we'll go fix area. We're just going to zero this thing in. And then adjust it from there. So we need to go... there. I always hate moving nodes because they're such a pain to move. We'll move that up to there. Okay, so then this one goes above it, and we'll go 2.32, 2.35, how about 2.4, okay. So then we'll go like this, and then we'll go negative, and Negative. Well, this one will have to move, I guess. Which is no big deal. I don't care if I gotta move it. Okay, so then we'll copy this. We'll go like this. And then we'll go 2.4. Okay, so now we get to go and make that. Okay, so now first what we need to do is we're just going to leave overloading in there for now, I guess. Function delete. That will delete. And then here, all this stuff that we added for that other thing, that's all gone. All that, gone. Perfect. So now we'll change all this stuff to flatbed before we forget. So we'll copy the flatbed part. Okay, and then we need, so we can delete those. So we need this, we need the mod desk and XMLs for this. Okay, so we need object attacher. Shoot. That's gotta go. Okay. So we gotta copy all this stuff here. Okay, let's just copy all this. And then we can delete what we don't need. So this goes right there like that. So we don't need this line because I'm not making a star category. I actually don't even want to do that anymore. I need to just remove that stuff from everything. But anyway, object attacher, dynamic mount attacher. We'll add those two to the line. Okay, so then we need to go scripts, and okay, let's just copy the whole scripts folder. That'd be a whole lot easier. Oh, guess it's already in there. So we're going to change that. Okay, we don't need to change anything there. So the input attacher. Okay, so then we need all this stuff. And that should be it. So this will go under the attacher joints. Oh wait, there aren't any attacher joints on this thing. So underneath break force. Or something, I don't know. We'll put it there. So, this is 023. So then these just all need to be set to 2, and then we'll be good. Okay, so now it's time to add the selectable items. So then we can delete that. So we'll go here and we'll get the 8030 out. So, we're going to copy this into the scripts folder. Oh, okay. We didn't really need it, I guess. But we'll just replace it anyways. Okay, so the mod desk, we need this piece. This piece. And then the 110N, so we'll copy this text because that's the only one that we need. Shoot. Okay, that is all that we need. Oh, but wait. That's gotta go there. There we go. So text. Hey rack. Or wait. Oh, yeah, we'll leave it as that. Toggle hay rack is what we'll put that as. Okay, so then we need input bindings. So we can get rid of that. And then we go hay rack. I feel like I'm missing something. Yeah, I am missing something from the stack mover. I am quite sure. Oops, not that. My desk. I gotta be missing something, because I gotta have the button. The button for locking it. I guess we'll find out. Okay, so we've got okay, so I guess we can save it. We'll go in and try it, and we'll see what happens. Zoom out nice and far on it. Grab a temporary store image. And we'll make sure we save this time. I'm not going to make that mistake again. Especially on camera. Okay. Save that image. Oh, we have one more thing to do in the mod desk. We got to change the price. To 7,800. What else do we gotta change? I think that's it. So we can take that, get that out of there. Okay, here we go. Okay, hopefully this will work this time. As a tractor, default color. Well, it purchased. So let's see, what do we got here? Yeah, we got nothing. Shoot. Well, it looks nice, though. Oh, you know what? Okay, I know what I did with the selection thing. I don't have the script for it. Oh. Oh, wait, yeah, I do. Toggle animated parts. So why? Huh. Man, that hurt. Okay, I can't figure out why this doesn't want to work now. Huh. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to mess around with this, but I gotta get this thing uploaded, or get it editing, get it uploaded, so, yeah, so I'm going to end the video here. tomorrow we will work on, tomorrow I'll have this all finished, and I'll show you guys, hopefully anyways, and then we'll work on the seed and fertilizer tender version tomorrow. So, thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias, my mod site, and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys. As always, we'll see you tomorrow.